पता इतिहास हमें याद रखेगा कि नहीं, लेकिन आज इतिहास हमसे लिखा जाएगा।
Gentlemen, may I just start by saying that was a really incredible teaser. That's very rousing, and really nicely done. One can see why. It's a film that's taken its time to sort of assemble. You know, the film tells the story of India's first civil rebellion against the British Empire, and it focuses on the freedom fighter Narasimha Reddy from Rayalaseema. Why was this a story, Charan, Chiranjeevi sir? Why was this a story that you wanted to tell, that you felt needed to be told?
No, 12 years back, it came to my notice, and some writers are there, Paruchuri brothers. And they told me this story, I mean, has to be brought into the light.
Right.
So, as a filmmakers, this story has all the love triangle and deprival, I mean, of the, among Maharajas.
Right.
And finally, he strived to get the independence.
Mm.
So, and above all, he was the first rebellion, first freedom fighter, much before Sepoy mutiny.
Right.
So I said, this story has to make. And that time, I didn't dare to make this movie because of the budget constraint. When I was, I mean, making films for 30 crores or 25-30 crores. That time, this budget, I mean, film estimated beyond 60-50 crores of rupees.
Right.
And that's the reason every time it's been postponing. And now, thanks to Bahubali,
right,
it has given us guts,
right,
I mean, way,
right,
to go even spend 200-300 crores.
Right. So, but you've been wanting to make it for about 12 years, yeah?
Yes, it was.
Over a decade. Over a decade, this has been happening. And for some reason, 2017, we did his comeback film after 10 years.
Yes.
That's his 150th film, and this is his 151.
Mm.
And I felt this is something he has to do it no matter what. And he never had a costume drama in his 150 films.
Right.
So I had a costume drama in my second movie with Rajeev Masand.
Yes.
And he was, that's a huge void which he was feeling at home. And I felt that was the one maybe waiting for him to be made.
And you decided to jump in as enabler.
And
really.
My mom's wish for 40 years now he's in the industry was to make a movie with my dad.
Right.
And I thought I'll just felicitate that.
Farhan Ritesh, you're involved as presenters of the Hindi version. You had, of course, great success releasing the Kannada film KGF a few months ago. But this chapter in history is about an uprising of 5,000 peasants in the Kurnool district, which now comes under Andhra Pradesh. It's not a very widely known chapter outside of the region, which the teaser itself acknowledges, that this is a person whose story needs to come out. What do you think will be the appeal of this story outside of the region?
Well, you know, I don't know if it really matters in terms of size of the number of people who are involved in it. I think what matters is the human spirit in this.
Mm.
And what matters is the need for independence, the need to be free, the need to be in control of your own destiny.
Mm.
I think that's the big thing. And that is something that anybody can identify with.
Right.
You know, so when you see films like this, it inspires you in whatever field of work you're in,
right,
or whatever endeavor you're in,
mm,
that, you know what, I mean, you should take a risk. You know, if there's a dream that you have, you should follow that dream,
mm,
no matter how difficult it seems or no matter how much the odds and obstacles are against you.
Right.
And that's what it does. So it's not necessarily per se only that, oh, I will be inspired to fight for freedom.
Mm.
You know, I'll be inspired to do something in my life.
Right.
You know, that is a challenge that people tell me maybe you can't do.
Correct.
You know, or that you can't have. It's aspirational,
right,
and that's really what the big connect with a film like this is.
Right. You know, traditionally, Ritesh, I mean, traditionally, films have not necessarily traveled outside of their regions. You know, Telugu films tend to work in Telugu. They're dubbed in Tamil and perhaps occasionally in Kannada and Malayalam. Bahubali is seen as the trigger as the film that kind of showed that you could do the pan Indian film. What are you going to do as, you know, as XL? What are you hoping to be able to bring to sort of expand that?
See, honestly, what moved me was the first time when Charan spoke to us and Anil and him came with the thing. The minute you talk of a story based on a true incident or a true character,
right,
right, it's an unsung hero.
Mm.
It's somebody who has been forgotten. So that itself is engaging. Yeah. And when I saw visuals of it, the way they had made the film, now obviously certain parts may have been fictionalized, but I don't know, but do I want to know the story? Correct. So I had the similar experience, which I'm sure the audience is going to have.
Right.
It was something I had not heard about.
Right.
I had no clue about this person. But the minute they showed me and they told me a little bit about it, so he took me through the film.
Mm.
And I said, God, like, you know, I said, like, I was, that's, and which I said earlier, I was really glad that he found us to be associated with the project. Because as a storyteller, you're always greedy for good stories, good content. And that's what drives all of us.
Right. Now,
and it doesn't matter, like, even when we did KGF, to be honest, everybody, when they saw the film, this is so not an Excel film. But what is not an Excel film?
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, is it a story? We watched it. And we loved it. We said, well, wow, I would love to, you know, do the same. I mean, we obviously saw that we were associated from the script level.
Correct.
But on this, it was something we feel like, you know, we'll miss out if we are not going to put names to it. You know, it's some story, I think, after it's made, obviously, you know, like the way they've put all their strength behind it and the sheer scale of it, it will be engaging, you know, and the way we are thinking about bringing the film. So I think rightfully so, by making it in Hindi, if you can widen the audience, and you should give it, you know. So I think that's the idea to doing it.
Sure. You know, the reason that a lot of historicals or a lot of stories from the past are made as films in the current times are because the themes, the larger themes, are still relevant today. You know, just as an example, when we make the story of Bhagat Singh today, the themes of having that clarity of purpose very early in one's life, in one's youth, is something that's very relevant. With Rani Lakshmibai, it's a story of valor among women, which is a much ignored sort of story. What are the big themes of Narasimha Reddy's story that feel extremely relevant today? Aside, of course, from the fact that this is a person whose story should just be out there. It's a story that should be, everyone should know.
I feel he was a guy who had no example ahead of him.
Mm.
Like,
it was unprecedented, yeah.
So even if you see the movie, the way we open it, is we open it from 1947 and then we rewind until his death.
Right.
And how that death happened and how he inspired Jhansi, Mangal Pandey, the sepoy and everything. So I feel his strength is, we're going to see what inspired him to be the first one to step forward.
Right.
I think that's his main thought.
What is
a thought which was so powerful that made him open up this gate, floodgate of everybody to have that strength to do that.
Do that.
So that'll be interesting.
He was inspiration even for Jhansi Lakshmibai and other freedom fighters.
We have Anushka playing Jhansi in the movie.
Right.
She just shot for the...
Yeah. Through Anushka character, Jhansi Lakshmibai character, my character will get introduced.
Right. You've really assembled this incredible cast. It feels like everyone's in this film. I mean, you're at the center of it. But there's Mr. Bachchan, and there's Sudeep, and there's Vijay Sethupathi, and there's Nayantara, and there's Anushka, and there's Tamanna. And I'm sure I'm missing out a few names. Was that hard to just put together, to assemble? Were they just drawn to the fact that it was a great story to tell? Did they want to, be able to sort of...
You're being associated with me.
That's right.
They accepted immediately. I mean, we didn't find much difficulty.
Like you said, not
making
too many
them
people
say yes.
Know about this character.
True.
Not only here.
Right.
I myself didn't know if my dad didn't read the script.
Correct. Okay.
I didn't know myself about this.
Yeah, many people they don't know
so
about the subject. It was not there in the books or in the academic studies.
It's more about them wanting to work with him and
have
this experience with him, and everybody have a small part of it, most of them.
Yeah. You know, very little, like you said, is known. And I tried to sort of Google and Wikipedia and see how much is known about Narasimha Reddy. And very little is, except that he died in 1846.
47.
February. 1847. Death by hanging.
Ah, yeah.
It's not clear how old he was at the time of the death, but it appears to be in his 30s. Did you have reservations about playing him, at 63?
I do, of course, but there, and screen presence, it doesn't matter.
Right.
I can bring down my age with my image. That way, it doesn't look what I am.
Sure. Charan, Surinder Reddy, who's the director of this film, is someone you work with on your film, Dhruva.
Yeah.
What were the challenges in bringing this story to the screen?
Initially, a great team, I think, is what the director needs.
Right.
And my challenge was to put together the team,
the great team
in terms of the technicians and the cast, So my director's job becomes really easy using his contacts, like he calling Mr. Bachchan and I calling few people. So we could make the director's job so easy, and I really wanted to focus, for him to focus on the crux of the scene and then educating all the actors what his intention and the behind every scene was. So it was an effort, but it was worth the effort.
You know, to all of you, I suppose today when you make a war film, if you make a film that deals with war, and if it's a costume drama, the comparisons to Bahubali are sort of inevitable. It's sort of the one that everyone watched. But your director has said that this is a more realistic story, which makes sense because it's a chapter in history. Is that a good comparison or not? You know, a good reference to if people sort of compare it to Bahubali, is that a good thing, or do films, you know, it's best to see films as they are and I mean, for what they are?
Comparison is inevitable. I mean, if there is a choice, I will say don't.
Right.
I'll try to slip away.
Right.
But when it's inevitable, now we all have to accept it gracefully and do our best. And I think as a team at 64 and at 34, we've done what we could do best, and we have our best partners like Farhan and Ritesh coming together, and Anil Thadani, we are doing our best in what we could do as a producers of India, as presenting a film and what it deserves to get.
Right.
So. But we are confident about the content of the film. It's a more based on realistic story and emotion-wise. And what all one commercial film has to be. And all the things are there in this film.
Mad.
That's the reason we are confident. Definitely people will accept. And which is convincing them also to accept this movie.
Yeah.
And comparison than, with the Bahubali, of course, that is a magnanimous and a humongous film. Salute to that, Bahubali.
Sure.
And one way we drew inspiration
from them.
From the Bahubali, as I was telling, it made us, spend
right it is the so confidence much. That there is
otherwise we cannot to do justice to this movie. We have to spend a lot for everything. We were for a war sequence in Tbilisi, Georgia. We were there for 1.5 months, and every day thousands of people and hundreds of horses and horsemen we have to engage. It's very, very expensive, but we never look back. He never
seriously, that strength that came way he has, from
that way Bahubali has inspired us. Okay, even if you spend, don't worry, you can get back.
Right.
So the that way we really thanks to Bahubali.
I mean, for you all, is Bahubali the benchmark in terms of, or was it just did the success of Bahubali kind of assure you that there is potential? Is that seen even from the business side? Is that seen as yes, that films can have that sort of pan-India appeal, and that films can do that pan-India business.
You know, I don't know. I mean, see, Bahubali and all. I mean, now Bahubali, when they did this, or they're doing Sahu, which is done in Hindi. I just feel it all depends, Rajeev, purely on the story and how exciting you make it. And the most simplest story, you take Avatar, which was done.
Right.
It's a simple story.
Mm.
Bahubali is actually a very simple story.
Correct.
It's a clear-cut, simple. It's not that you've not seen the similar. It's just the way that director brought that story to life and made it in the presentation. Now, similar, this story, like I said, it's an unsung hero. I think it's got certain advantages because A, it's based on a real life. So you'll obviously have to. It is still simple in its way.
It is
one line which actually drew me immediately, which I told you earlier.
Yeah.
Is that when you talk of an unsung hero and the first rebel against the British, now we all know that.
Right.
You know, like, and now like you were saying, if he was the first rebel who
inspired
all
Rani
the
Lashubai
other things, so that means you want to know
who was that person,
like who gave the birth to that.
Right.
You know? So I think it's there, and like you said, people are coming into theaters. They're wanting to watch films.
Right.
You know, it's like we always keep saying, us going to cinemas today. I mean, we're still under screen.
Right.
So now with these movies coming in, you're filling in more people, and I'm pretty sure the way the teaser has worked out, they released behind the scenes before.
Right.
It has created a curiosity. People want to come and see it. And if you excite them with it, I think you're home with it, you know.
I mean, are these exciting times? Do you feel like these are just exciting times where, you know, films don't have to have to only play in your markets? You know, does it feel like this is just an exciting time where one can have, you know, your entire country can be your audience? And does that feel different? Do you feel like for too long, one was perhaps forced to think small because one only thought that, you know, this was the market of your film, that these were your viewers?
I mean, it is definitely exciting because for 12 years, what is in just right. papers and written and shown it to him was coming up really in theaters now.
Long.
So it's, yeah, it's definitely exciting.
Long awaited movie for me. And really, the way he's telling, I mean, for his second movie, he acted Magadhira.
That's right.
I didn't have the chance to work in the costumes, drama, folk.
Did you enjoy that?
Really, I enjoyed it.
And do you
working.
Feel like, you know, the wait was worth it? I mean, you waited 12 years to make
yes,
this. Was
it's
it all
worth the waiting. That's why I'm confident about this movie, about the content. With all my experience, I can tell. It is, I mean, scene after scene, it is mounting up, and it went to a pinnacle there at story end.
Right.
So definitely, yes.
Charan, the film that you're currently making with Mr. Rajamouli is also a story of freedom struggle, right?
Yeah.
Very little is known, I know. But it is that, you know, in the way that, I don't want to sound cynical, but in the way that, you know, in Europe, the Holocaust will always inspire stories, or certain events in history will always inspire, you know, compelling stories. Is our freedom struggle, you know, the gift that keeps on giving in that sense?
Well, to a certain extent, there's a lot to learn about that time. I mean, sir mentioned, in school, we were taught, you know, what everybody knows.
Correct.
You know, like the broad strokes.
Right.
You know, but when you look at the details, the finer, you know, like the pixels,
right.
you know, who all played a part in it,
right.
you'll find stories and you'll find heroes in places you never imagined, you know, you never heard of. I mean, like, for example, this film is about a person who inspired other people to fight,
right.
you know, and he had no predecessor before him to give him that inspiration.
Correct.
So similarly, I'm sure you'll keep finding stories like this, and it's really good. I mean, there's always yeah. learning from it.
Right.
You know, you'll always get, the more you know about history, you know, hopefully the more you can correct yourself in the future.
Right.
You know, that's the one of the biggest things, is to learn from your past.
Right.
So if you can learn from these people, learn from the experiences, and hopefully it'll teach you things, you know, about the future.
Right. Chiranjeevi sir, what was your son like as a producer?
He's a smart guy. And in my career, I focused only on film acting.
That's right.
You know, so I don't have intentions to do any kind of business,
right.
but they're smart enough, and they're balancing his profession as an actor and doing business also.
Right.
I think he will be a successful business person, definitely.
Charan, did you have to, you know, you're wearing two hats. You're wearing the hat of son and producer in this film. I mean, did they ever come in conflict? You know, as a producer, some decisions are easier to take. As a son, those decisions might be harder. No, you know, we can shoot this big and not this much. Were those ever in conflict?
I mean, I lie if I say I haven't been in that situation. Yeah, it is.
He had a good presenter, the mother, right. the financier.
Right.
Yeah.
So the smart thing is, I involved all the ladies of the house into the
right.
Into the system. So I had my sister who did the costumes. I had Stylist. My mom who takes
Present.
Care of his everything, you know. So, and then I had my other cousin who was the CEO of my company.
Uh-huh.
So it's like Dad said, I'm really not smart. I'm just smart in putting people around him, the right people, and then then do my own thing and just oversee the whole thing.
Sorry, but if I may also add, you know, mm-hmm. I mean, also this is again from experience of having worked with my dad
yeah.
on many projects.
Yes.
You know, I feel that obviously because time changes, the way films are made change.
Mm.
But there is, and there's of course a certain enthusiasm and excitement that you have as somebody younger who's come into the film industry.
Right.
But there is experience, you know, that your parents have.
Of course.
There is, of course, the respect that they command.
Right.
And it's for them, you know, to recognize and to behave and understand in a certain way of how easy they make you feel.
Right.
Absolutely.
You know, it's not about you. It's not, you can't demand something. You
right.
know, you can't say you have to do this or I won't. You know what I mean? It's not
right.
about that.
Correct.
It's them adapting to the time. You know, it's about them saying, okay, you know what, I know what I bring to the table, you know, but let me also listen to what's happening now. You know, and that nobody can get somebody to do. I mean, that comes with maturity, that comes with experience, and that comes with respect for whoever you're working with, regardless of the number of films and the age that of the person that you're working with.
He's 100% right. I mean, in many, many days, many shoots where Dad was saying I was, maybe we were pushing him or the situation was not very comfortable.
Right.
Because of the costume, the weight of the costume, the weight of the wig and the swords and everything, the horse. It can just catch up to you one day, but never till date. I'm not saying because he's here, he's ever complained. He made the journey so easy for us. We were like, when is this volcano going to burst? In these 270 days we shot over 2.5 years, not a single day.
You know, that's true. If the volcano bursts, what do you do?
Yeah. Right.
You know, there's nothing you can do. Yeah. So it's completely up to the volcano to decide.
How did the volcano stay calm?
Just because of my experience. Or whatever, I never had anything. So I know the director and everybody is very sincerely, they are doing their job well.
Right.
So I think everything is in right place. Yeah. So it will happen. All things sometimes it may delay a little bit.
Right.
And it may exceed budget wise a little bit. But we prepared for everything. And that's the reason I was so composed. I believe in Charan, director's direct job and everything, so cool.
Finally, before we go, have you seen, I mean, how much have you seen of the film, each of you, and does that inspire confidence? Does it make you a little anxious? Are you excited about showing it to the rest of the world?
I have not seen much.
Okay.
It's only Dad who's seen it through the dubbing and seeing other works of the film.
Right.
I think Farhan, me and Ritesh are yet to see.
We've all just seen the teaser. The rest of us have just seen the teaser. Yeah.
Well, I've seen a little more.
Maybe Ritesh and I have seen a little
and
more.
And that inspires Farhan. Confidence, Ritesh?
Yeah, totally.
I myself as a producer, I've seen as much as they've seen as well.
So then, sir, you have to have the final words. Yeah, if you've seen it all.
Yes. And whatever may you expect, so it will go beyond your expectations.
Wonderful.
That I'm very much confident that way.
Lovely. Yes. That's actually a lot of confidence. Thank you so much.
Thank
Looking
you,
forward
Rajeev.
To watching the film. More power. Thank you so much.
So
thank you.
So
thank you. Thank you.